All right, so we've made it. I can't believe this. We've made it up to the canopy. It is so beautiful up here.
And now we're going to collect a plant. How about this one?
So we're really interested in understanding this process of transmission, how the insect carries the bacteria from tree to tree.
Well, Crystal is an excellent example of a scientist who's using their living collections in her dissertation research. Shall we go say hi to your trees?
Yeah, let's do it.
On Science in Real Life, we've gotten to see some incredible tree scientists in action. They work on everything from how trees will be affected by climate change.
As you know, the planet's climate is warming, and one result of this climate change is widespread drought. The main motivating question of my research is how will trees respond to drought?
To the different strategies that tree buds use to survive the winter.
Lots of temperate trees make specialized leaves around the outside of the buds, which we call scale leaves or bud scales, and they look very different from the foliage leaves. But not all temperate trees make scale leaves, and for my dissertation, I want to try and find out why.
To fighting diseases that are decimating our citrus tree crops.
And our hypothesis is that not all insects are actually able to transmit the bacteria. Yeah. So if we have some that do and some that don't, we can begin to understand by comparing them how this process actually occurs.
And possibly figure out how to prevent it.
Exactly, yep.
And even the tree of life.
So making a phylogenetic tree is a little bit like making a genealogy or a family tree. So the systematics part is really what we call biodiversity sciences. It's trying to understand the huge number of species out there. And then the molecular part is to try to use DNA-based characters. The genes have secrets about the way that the plants originated, how they're related, and the timing of those things.
To answer these questions, they measure the pressure of the water being pulled up tree trunks, X-ray buds to see what's happening to the immature leaves packaged inside, test the ability of insects to spread disease among citrus trees, and sequence the DNA of countless plant species to analyze their evolutionary relationships. We visited so many places dedicated to researching and protecting trees, allowing future generations to enjoy our arboreal friends in all their glory, like
Harvard Forest. The forest is 4,000 acres of woodland located in Petersham, Massachusetts. It was founded in 1907 to be used for long-term research projects and education.
And
UC Berkeley's Herbarium, a research collection of 2.2 million dried plant specimens. One of the huge advantages of preserving plants in herbaria is that their DNA is preserved too. We can sample plants that are 100 years old and still get sequence data from them.
When herbaria were first started, we didn't even know what DNA was. So we're constantly coming up with new ways to use herbarium collections as our technology advances.
And the Boyce Thompson Institute, which is dedicated to using plant biology research to improve agriculture, protect the environment, and enhance human health. And the Arnold Arboretum of Harvard University.
The Arnold Arboretum is the oldest public arboretum in North America. It's an extraordinary collection of over 2,100 species of woody plants from around the world. There are 15,000 individual organisms that we keep track of here. So this is an amazing tree behind us, but it's not only meant to be looked at, they're meant to be studied for scientific purposes. We have a huge research building here, and it's filled with graduate students, undergraduates, professors from around the world, and they come here because we have these extraordinary organisms, and they do research here.
Okay, so I think by now we've convinced you we are big fans of trees on Science IRL, and we are proud to make it official by being part of Team Trees, a massive collaboration across all of YouTube whose goal is to plant 20 million trees by the end of the year. So to do this, Team Trees has partnered with the Arbor Day Foundation, which has agreed to plant one tree for every dollar donated as part of this effort. So please head on over to teamtrees.org to turn your dollars into trees. We hope you'll rise to the occasion. Anyway, yay trees! Be sure to visit teamtrees.org. There's a link in the description, and links to all of the episodes you've ever made about tree scientists are in there as well, so be sure to check those out and subscribe. Go Team Trees!